Hello students, in my today's lecture I shall explain you what is PN junction rectifier. In my previous class I explained you what is rectifier and how to decide the performance of a rectifier. But in my today's lecture I shall explain you how a PN junction acts as a rectifier. The first question comes to mind that why do we use a PN junction as a rectifier? It is because we have seen that a PN junction can be either forward biased or reverse biased. Now, if a PN junction is forward biased, then it conducts heavily. But when a PN junction is reverse biased and the reverse voltage is less than the breakdown voltage, then the PN junction does not conduct because majority charge carriers do not flow at all. Thus, we see that when a PN junction is forward biased, it conducts heavily. But when a PN junction is reverse biased with reverse voltage less than breakdown voltage, it does not conduct. So this property of the PN junction diode helps it to use it as a rectifier. So look here, I have written that a PN junction can act as a rectifier because it conducts when forward biased and practically does not conduct when reverse biased. So here you must keep in mind that reverse voltage must be less than the breakdown voltage which we call VBD of the diode. So if the reverse voltage is less than breakdown voltage of the diode, then the diode will not conduct, so there will be no current. Okay, now PN junction rectifier, PN junction diode rectifier, or simply we call it diode rectifier. So this diode rectifier is of two types: half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. Half wave rectifier, as you know, the input given to the rectifier is alternating voltage. Alternating voltage means it has a full cycle. So if the rectifier circuit can convert only half cycle of input AC, only half cycle, full cycle and half cycle. See, full cycle. This is full cycle. Now if the rectifier circuit only converts half cycle, suppose this half cycle is rectified and the other half is not rectified, then that type of rectifier is known as half wave rectifier. So a half wave rectifier is the rectifier which converts half cycle of input AC to DC. Full wave rectifier means a rectifier which converts the full cycle of AC to DC, that is called full wave rectifier. Now this full wave rectifier is further classified as center tapped full wave rectifier and bridge rectifier. ब्रिज टाइप फूल वेव रेक्टिफायर. नाउ लेट अस फर्स्ट डिस्कस अबाउट हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर. सो हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट इट इज द रेक्टिफायर व्हिच कन्वर्ट्स ओनली हाफ साइकिल ऑफ इनपुट एसी टू डीसी. ओके, सो लुक हियर, पीएन जंक्शन डायोड एज ए हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर. दिस इज द सर्किट डायग्राम. लुक एट दिस सर्किट डायग्राम. इन दिस सर्किट डायग्राम दिस इज द पीएन जंक्शन डायोड. डी डी मीन्स पीएन जंक्शन डायोड. दिस इज द पी मेटेरियल एंड दिस बार इज द एन मेटेरियल ऑफ द डायोड. नाउ दिस इज द ट्रांसफॉर्मर. ट्रांसफॉर्मर हैज टू वाइंडिंग्स, दैट इज प्राइमरी वाइंडिंग पी एंड सेकेंडरी वाइंडिंग एस. टू वाइंडिंग्स आर देयर, प्राइमरी वाइंडिंग एंड सेकेंडरी वाइंडिंग. The RL is the load resistance where we get the output, and this is the AC source of EMF. Means this will give you alternating voltage. So this is the circuit diagram. So you have to explain this circuit diagram. As shown in the circuit diagram, D is a PN junction diode. This diode is connected with a transformer and a load resistance RL. The transformer has two windings, primary winding P and secondary winding S. The primary winding of the transformer is connected with an alternating source of EMF AC, and the secondary winding is connected to the junction diode D, and to get the output we have taken the load resistance. Now what is the function of transformer here? The function of transformer is like this. So function of transformer, number one, transformer converts steps up or steps down the input AC voltage given to the primary. And number two, the transformer helps in isolating the primary, diode circuit from the AC source. This reduces the chances of getting shock. So this is the function of the transformer. So after describing the circuit diagram, we have to study how this circuit works. So next step is working of the rectifier. Now look at the working of the half wave rectifier circuit, how it works. See, the AC which is to be rectified, we want to rectify this AC. This is applied to the primary winding of the transformer. Now this transformer simply converts AC to AC, but If it is high voltage, it will be low voltage AC. If it is low voltage, it will be high voltage. But AC will be AC. That means both we get AC both at the primary and secondary of the transformer. Usually we make use of a step down transformer. Step down transformer. In a step down transformer, the input AC voltage is high, but the voltage appearing across the secondary is low voltage. So when the AC voltage appears across the secondary, the polarity of the two points A and B, the polarity, that will change after every half cycle. Polarity means positive and negative. So that will change after every half cycle. Suppose, so that I have written here, when AC is applied to the primary P of the transformer TR, it appears across the secondary S. Because of AC, the polarities of points A and B changes after every half cycle. Suppose initially, during positive half cycle of input AC, point A is positive and point B is negative. Okay? So this AC, this has two half cycles. This is positive half cycle, this is negative half cycle. Okay? Now, suppose during this positive half cycle, this is the positive half cycle, point A is positive and point B is negative. So what will happen? The P material of the diode, P material of the diode will be positive and N material of the diode will be negative. That means the diode will be forward biased. P material, N material. P material positive, N material negative. So the diode will be forward biased. And when the diode will be forward biased, it will conduct. The current will flow through the load resistance RL, current will flow. So this is the current. So current will flow through the load resistance RL. And we shall get the output. So output voltage is equal to I out into RL. So if this is I out, output current, so I out into RL. In the next half cycle, means this half cycle of input AC, that is negative half cycle of input AC, automatically point A will be negative and point B will be positive. So the P material will be negative, N material will be positive. That means the diode will be reverse biased. The diode will be reverse biased. And as the peak voltage appearing across the secondary is less than the breakdown voltage of the diode, therefore this diode will not conduct during the negative half cycle. So as it will not conduct, there will be no current. That means what we have seen, that In the full cycle of AC, we are getting output current for positive half cycle because diode is conducting, and we are not getting current at the output during the negative half cycle because diode is reverse biased. So we can say now that this diode D is able to rectify only the positive half cycle. It is unable to rectify the negative half cycle. After that, again the positive half cycle will come. So diode will be first, then negative half cycle will come, the diode will be reverse biased. So this is how alternately the diode conducts only during the positive half cycles, and it does not conduct during the negative half cycles. So the diode is able to rectify the positive half cycles of input AC. It is unable to rectify the negative half cycles. Hence, its name is the half wave rectifier. Half wave rectifier. Okay? So that I have mentioned here, that this makes the diode forward biased and it conducts and current flows through the load RL. Okay? This part is clear. That during the positive half cycle of input AC, point A is positive and point B is negative. This makes diode D forward biased. So it conducts and current flows through load RL. In the next half cycle, that is negative half cycle, point A becomes negative while point B becomes positive. This makes diode D reverse biased. So diode does not conduct as a peak value of EMF E0 is less than the breakdown voltage of diode. So, this is how the half-wave rectifier circuit is able to rectify only the positive half cycles of input AC to DC. It is unable to rectify the negative half cycles. So, I have completed the half part of the rectifier. In the next class, I shall explain you its input and output waveforms and also its efficiency and ripple factor. How efficiently this rectifier circuit is performing its rectification process.